So X and Y are independent random variables where X was uniform on the interval from 0 to 1 and Y was exponential with parameter beta equals 1. And beta would be the mean. So the mean of Y is 1. Use the CDF method to find the PDF for the maximum of X and Y. And it's tricky, it's piecewise. Gotta think carefully. Let's look by hand first. V is the maximum of X and Y. That's the transformation. The derivative formula from chapter 4 would not work here. It would not be helpful. You got to use the CDF method. Because, like, well, the transformation is it's actually a transformation of two variables instead of one, for one thing. And it's a maximum. How do you differentiate a maximum? Can you? You got to use the CDF method. Capital F subcapital V of little v. Always matching those variables. Make one a capital letter, make one a lowercase letter. It's the probability that capital V is less than or equal to little v, which is the probability that the maximum of X and Y is less than or equal to little v. Which means if the maximum of two numbers, two quantities is less than or equal to some other number, then both of them have to be. X is less than or equal to little v and Y is less than or equal to little v. And here's where you use independence. Assuming X and Y are independent, we can use the multiplication rule for independent events. Since X and Y are independent. We're making that as an assumption. When you're doing simulations, if you simulate them separately with random variate, that will automatically be true. Random variate is simulating them independently. So by the way, here are two examples of non-independent variables. Z and Y are very dependent. If you know Z, you know Y. But here, X and Y are independent, I'm assuming. Could I assume they're dependent? Yeah, I could make various kinds of assumptions of dependency, like maybe a direct relationship between them, but that's not so interesting and maybe not so clear what to do if you did. Now use the CDFs of X and Y individually, but you gotta be careful about domain. X again is uniform 0, 1. Y is exponential with a mean of 1. X has to be between 0 and 1, but Y can be any positive number. Just because its mean is 1 doesn't mean it couldn't take on a value of a million. Extremely unlikely, but theoretically possible. The CDFs for X and Y are what these are. You could write, you don't have to write this, but you could say this is capital F sub X of little v times capital F sub Y of little v. Keep the little v consistent. Technically, these are defined for all v, but with X, it's only something non-trivial when v is between 0 and 1. Right, capital F sub X, I'll use a little x here, is, well, if I want to be fully thorough here, 0 if X is less than 0, leave some space and write a 1 if X is greater than 1. And something else if x is between 0 and 1. What is the something else? The CDF of a uniform 0, 1. It's very simple. X. This graph looks like this. Zero, when the output's zero, you're going to get zero there. When V is zero, the answer is zero. You don't have to bother with that case, but you do need to think about these two cases separately. And they're going to affect the answer. The answer is going to be piecewise here. When V is between zero and one, the output of F, capital F sub X, is just the input, V. When V is between or greater than one, then the output of F sub capital X is one. CDF of Y, which is exponential with mean one, I hope you were able to figure out to be, if little y is positive, at least capital F sub capital Y of little y ends up being 1 minus e to the negative y. That's something you had to figure out. The PDF is just e to the negative y. CDF is an integral of that, but not any old integral. It's got to be this one. Not any old antiderivative. This one has a limit as that y goes to infinity of 1. And a value, limiting value as y approaches 0 of 0. And that stays the same, but use a v instead of a y. It's the same in both cases. So there's the CDF of capital V. Differentiate it now to find the PDF. Making the PDF piecewise as well. Now, technically speaking, the PDF is not differentiable at 0 or 1. While capital F is continuous at 1, it's not differentiable there. If you graphed it, you didn't have to graph it, but I did. If you graph it, it looks about like this. And then it's got like a corner there. That's what the graph of this function looks like. And there's a lack of differentiability at one. But it's not a real big deal just as a single point, because you know, you're going to integrate little f and single values don't matter. Integrate it at least if you want to find the mean. Here we're just after, well, integrate v times it if you want to find the mean, which you do later on. Just differentiate this. I need the product rule with the second thing. And the chain rule, and it looks like I get that, and then I get this. And I believe the graph of this PDF ends up looking about like I'm not sure if it starts at zero or not. As V goes to zero, or does this go to zero? Yeah, okay. I think it looks something like this with jump discontinuity at one. And in fact, you could even say open circles at both spots. It's highest just less than one. The data are most dense just less than one. And they get less dense just bigger than one, a lot less dense. if you did simulate when you do simulations. In my solution key, I defined the CDF of X. I differentiated it to find the PDF of X. That was the uniform 01. Here is the Y, which has exponential with mean one. And here I did V and W CDFs. That's V, the maximum. W, you need to use the, that's the minimum. You need to use the addition rule, which is essentially what that equation is doing. Y. W is the min of X and Y. It's CDF, as always, is this kind of thing. But now for the min to be less than or equal to a given number means or X or Y is less than or equal to W. Instead of and. But then you can use the addition rule. That's the same as the probability that X is less than or equal to W plus the probability that Y is less than or equal to W minus the probability that X is less than or equal to W and Y is less than or equal to W. And then with this one, you can use independence and write it as a product. So that's what I did here on that line. Then I differentiated them to find their PDFs and I made graphs. The one on the left is for the maximum. The one on the right is for the minimum. Minimum's gotta be between 0 and 1, by the way. X is uniform 0, 1, it never goes bigger than 1. Y could be bigger than 1, but you're taking the min, so you're never going to get a min bigger than 1. So the domain of W is 0 to 1. These calculations compute the means and second moments of V and W, both as an exact form and approximate form. So the exact first moment, the mean of V, I guess this is just V, excuse me, is that, and its approximate mean is 1.13. The exact second moment, not variance, second moment of V is that, it's exactly this. Then this is computing the variance. Take its square root, this is the standard deviation. Same kind of thing for W here. Okay, so you should have, for V, a mean of about 1.13, standard deviation of about 0.92. For W, mean of about 0.37, standard deviation of about 0.27. As far as number four went, simulating with random variate, there's various ways I think you could have done it. Here's the way I decided to do it. So I use random variate with uniform distribution and exponential distribution to generate X data and Y data. And then I found V data and W data this way. I used table, and maybe there's a way to do this without table, or maybe you just did something different. Table generates lists. I'm taking the maximum values of corresponding X data and Y data values as I, the iterator for the location of the X and Y data goes from 1 to 100, and generating then a list of V data, maximum data, doing something similar with minimum. And then I do mean, standard deviation for both of those. And every time you enter this, you're going to get a different answer. But approximately, the mean of V here for this run, okay, close to 1.11, close to that 1.13. Standard deviation, 0.88, close to, hopefully, 0.92. Yeah, not too far. For the minimum, mean, 0.35, close to 0.37. And standard deviation, 0.29, close to 0.27. Okay. Again, there's probably, you guys probably did this in a different way if you were able to do it. That's the way I chose to do it. Not going to go over the deductible problem, but I believe if I need to double check things, but I believe I got a mean, well, I got a mean of 818.7. So if you got that, does that sound right? Did you get that now, or you have a question? Because the minimum will never be bigger than one, since x is never bigger than one. So if you got 818 for the mean of y for the deductible problem, that's what I got. I'm not positive it's right yet. I need to double check things. The CDF has a discontinuity at zero. The CDF value at zero, I got to be 0.18. So if you got that, that's good. It's the same as the probability that x is less than 200. So you have to integrate the exponential distribution to find that. X is exponential with a mean of 1,000. So its PDF is 0.001 times e to the negative 0.001x. Integrating that from 0 to 200 gives you the probability that x is less than 200, which means the insurance payment is zero. The deductible is the only thing the person pays. And insurance pays nothing.